step on up. It's time to read a story now. Super awesome fun, you'll see. Come on in, the story's round the corner now. Super awesome story time with me. Hello everyone, it's Crystal here from Super Awesome Storytime. I'm so excited to read another story with you all during this festive season. These are my friends.
Hello.
Say hello.
Hi.
Hello.
And we're very excited to be reading a wonderful story with you today. But before we find out what's behind the story pillow, should we sing a festive song to get us into the mood? Wonderful. Well, what should we... Hang on a minute. I think we should sing a song that is about a little reindeer that might have a red nose. Do you know that song? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. That's it. All right. Let's get ready to sing our song. Let's start by clapping our hands. Here we go. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names like Pinocchio. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, "Ho, ho, ho, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?" Then how the reindeer loved him, and they shouted out with glee, "Yippee! Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you'll go down in his story. Yay!" Give yourselves a big round of applause. Thank you, Santa. Ho, ho, ho. And thank you so much, my friend, for letting me borrow your reindeer ears. Oh, well, I'm feeling nice and warm now. How about you? Wonderful. Well, before we find out what the story is, should we guess what the story might be about? Wonderful. Okay, you go first. What do you think today's story might be about? Ooh, it could be about that. That's a great suggestion. Well, what do I think it's about? Ooh, what do you think it's... Hang on. Oh, this Teddy thinks it might be about some bubbles. And, oh, Santa Teddy. Think it might be about falling snow. Alright, I think they're good suggestions. I'll go with those. Alright, let's find out what's behind the story pillow. Here we go. Rupert's snowman. Santa Teddy, I think you were very right. There is definitely some beautiful falling snow in this story. Oh, I'm very excited. Have you seen snow before? Wonderful. Alright, shall we get started? Okay. Here we go! Rupert's Snowman, written by Phillipa Warden and illustrated by Grace Ward. It was Christmas Eve. A blanket of snow had wrapped the hills and fields that lay about the cottage. Look at all of that beautiful snow and that cottage amongst it. Rupert stood at the window, flapping with excitement. There's Rupert. I'd be excited too if I saw snow. After breakfast, his mummy rummaged in the garage for the sledge. Ooh, a sledge. I guess that's another word for tobogganing, when you sit and you go sliding down the snow hills. Have you been on a sledge before? Or a sleigh? Or a toboggan? Wonderful. Me too. It's so much fun. They packed a rucksack with a flask of steaming hot chocolate and some gingerbread snaps. Ooh, yummy. They wound their scarves around and around until they could just peep out and set off to the top of the hill. Well, they look nice and snug. I guess if it's snowing, that means it must be very cold. Stopping sometimes to make a snow angel, the two made their way to the top. Have you made a snow angel before? Where you get your arms and flap your snow angel wings. Can you do that too? Oh, beautiful snow angels. Rupert began to roll the fluffy snow to make the best snowman that had ever been built. It stood almost as tall as his mummy. Wow, check out that snowman. It is very tall. They used stones for the eyes, nose, mouth, and buttons. They pulled at bare sticks in the hedgerow for arms. Look at that. There are the stones and the sticks to make the snowman's arms. It was missing something. A hat! Of course, you can't build a snowman without a hat. Rupert drained the last of the hot chocolate from his cup. What do you think he's going to do with that cup now that he's drunk all that delicious hot chocolate? Let's find out. He popped the cup upside down on the snowman's head. A dribble of cocoa looked like hair. It was perfect. It does look like hair. Check it out. Accidentally perfect. The snowman watched as the pair sledged down the hill, had snowball fights, and decorated the winter wonderland with angels. Wow, it looks like they're having the best fun. There they are going down the hill. There's Rupert, snow angels. It looks like there are some other people having fun in the snow too. When it was time for lunch, they raced down the hill one last time. The snowman seemed to be waving goodbye in a slight breeze. Who will look after Frosty? Rupert asked, tears welling in his eyes. Oh, poor Frosty. Rupert's worried he'll be left there all alone. The birds, the mice, and the deer tonight, came the reply. There they are, the birds, the mice, and of course, the reindeer, just like Rudolph. We'll be looking after Frosty tonight. We can't leave him! And off he flew, racing back up the hill. He threw his arms around Frosty and whispered his plan. I wonder what he said to Frosty. Together they rolled the last of the three snowballs onto the sledge. Well, I'm going to guess that these three snowballs Frosty. I think they might be taking him somewhere with them. What do you think? Let's find out. Carefully laying the twigs and stones beside them. I think we might be right. Oh. Rupert squealed as he rebuilt Frosty next to the apple tree. Frosty did come home with them, right next to their cottage. There he is, building the snowman. Back up. Boop, 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 boop. He built a snow sister, a snow dog, woof, and two snow kittens. Meow. Can you see them there? The snow sister, there's the dog, and the two cats. Very cute. Just before he went to bed, Rupert looked at the scene lit up by the flickering light of the log fire through the living room window. An entire snow family to keep Frosty company while Rupert waited for Father Christmas to arrive. There's Rupert looking out the window at this beautiful snow family. The end! Wasn't that fun? Have you built a snowman before, just like Frosty in the book? Oh, so great! And did yours have a hat? Or a hot chocolate cup with some eyes and some buttons. Amazing. Oh, that's so wonderful. What a beautiful book. Is it snowing where you are at Christmas time? Well, where I come from in Nam, Melbourne, Australia, it is not snowing at all. The sun is shining. I wonder what it would be like to have a snowy Christmas. Well, speaking of Christmas, I think I know a Christmas song that would be perfect to sing after reading this wonderful book. But you know what? I think I need some very special friends to help me. Let me go find them. Whoop!
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over fields we go, laughing all the way. Ho, ho, ho! Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open ourselves a big round of applause. That was wonderful. Thank you so much, Eliza and Francesca, for teaching me how to sign Jingle Bells. I hope you enjoyed learning it too. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for reading this wonderful book with me. Also, fabulous. And speaking of all things fabulous, check out this incredible artwork that I received. Ooh, whoop. Now, I received 3 awesome works of art from Yasmin. Check out this first one. It is Christmas themed with a Christmas tree made out of paper in beautiful patterns here, and it is sitting in a very happy little pot plant. Isn't that amazing? Look at all the beautiful colours of the baubles that she has cut out and stuck on, as well as the Christmas tree star. Does your Christmas tree look like this too? It is pretty cool. Check out the next artwork. Ooh, whoop. Here she has made a Christmas tree decoration. Isn't that incredible? A Christmas tree, but different this time, cut out of paper, but it looks like there might be some stickers on here. I can see a beautiful little penguin. It looks like there might be a reindeer on ice skates, and a Christmas stocking, and a few other things. Hey, can you spot a sneaky little Christmas elf on the shelf in here? Oh, look closely. Ooh. Oh. There he is. And check out this next awesome artwork by Yasmin. Ooh, whoop. Here is Yasmin's lucky last work of art. She has drawn an elf on the shelf, sitting in fact on a shelf with a little present next to it. Oh, have you seen the elf on the shelf in your house? Or just an elf hanging around anywhere? Maybe not, because they must be very, very busy on the North Pole. But here is one here. Thank you so much, Yasmin, for sharing all of these incredible works of art. I love them. They are amazing. Very festive indeed. If you would like to share your artwork on Super Awesome Storytime, I would love to see it. So please take a picture of whatever it is you're creating and send it on through to me, and I will make sure to share it on the next Super Awesome episode. And if you're wondering where you can find Super Awesome Storytime, well, you can find it on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. So please hit the like and subscribe button. And you can find lots of up-to-date, super awesome content there. Thank you so much for tuning in, everyone. Have a wonderful holiday and festive season. And I will see you very soon. See you later. Bye. Whoop.
Step on up. It's time to read a story now. Super awesome fun, you'll see. Come on in. The story's round the corner now. Super awesome story time with me.